Hey, this is the Old Gaming Geezer, and we're back playing some Fallout 4, and I have just arrived at the gates of Diamond City. That young lady you can see in the background was helped get me in because there was the gate was closed and she had to bluff our way in. She is a local. It seems she's a reporter named Piper, and she's not well-liked by the mayor, and I believe that's the mayor she's talking to. So let's go take a look. What's going on here?
Who let you back inside? I told Sullivan to keep that gate shut. You devious, rabble-rousing slanderer. The level of dishonesty in that paper of yours. I'll have that critter scrapped for parts.
Mr. McDonough, tyrant mayor shuts down the press. Why don't we ask the newcomer? You support the news? Because the mayor's threatened to throw free speech in the dumpster.
I support the news.
Always believed in freedom of the press.
It's one of the foundations of a free society.
Hell yeah.
Oh, I didn't mean to bring you into this argument, good sir. No.
Good sir.
You look
and my
like
friend in the power armor.
City material.
Yes.
Welcome to the great green jewel of the Commonwealth. Safe, happy, a fine place to come. Spend your money. Settle down. Don't let this muckraker here tell you otherwise.
What are you two arguing about?
What are you two arguing about, anyway?
What do you think? Print lies and everybody's happy, but if you print the truth...
Now, was there anything particular you came to our city for?
Yeah, I'm looking for something.
Just looking for something?
Oh, what is it you're looking for?
Missing person.
Who would I talk to about finding a missing person?
Well, whatever you do, don't bother going to Diamond City Security for help.
Don't listen to her. Well, I'm afraid that our security team can't follow every case that comes through. I'm confident that you can find help here. Diamond City
okay.
Has every conceivable service known to man. One of our great
really?
Citizens can surely find the time to help.
Every conceivable service? Okay, well, who can help?
Sure, and... A mayor of a great city must know everyone. Who can help me?
Well, I'm sorry, I don't have time for any more questions. I'm a busy man.
I thought I had high charisma.
Enjoy your stay in our
obviously not high enough.
This is ridiculous. I want the truth, McDonough. What's the real reason security always shrivels away when talk of missing persons comes
up? I've had enough of this, Piper. From now on, consider you and that little sister of yours on notice.
Yeah, keep talking, McDonough. That's all you're good for. A big Diamond City welcome from the mayor. You feel honored yet?
Yes, I do.
Look, I gotta go get settled in, but stop by my office later. I have an idea for an article you'd be perfect for.
Ooh. And my wife just died. I'm on the rebound. So Diamond City, huh? Guy looks like a raider. Oh, Diamond Security. Diamond City Security. Oh, this is Danny. She was arguing with this guy on the radio outside.
You're Sullivan, right?
So, you're that traitor Piper was talking about.
What?
Something tells me she's pulled the wool over my eyes again.
I think... Right? I'm going to apologize.
I didn't mean to lie, officer. It all just happened so fast.
Oh, sure it did. Happened so fast you forgot all about basic human decency. Didn't your mother ever teach you to be honest?
My mother's dead.
What's brought you into town anyway? Be good to note it down in the logs.
Missing person.
I'm trying to find someone.
Is that so? Who are you looking for?
A boy. My son.
My boy Sean's been kidnapped. He's just a baby.
Oh, look, I'm sorry, but we're under orders not to get involved in missing person cases. There's a
really?
Lot of institute paranoia right now. We can't really risk fanning those flames with official action. What if people panic?
Tell me about the Institute.
The Institute? What's that?
Ah, damn. Look, I really shouldn't have said that. They're just a scapegoat, all right? Something people blame when things go wrong. If you really want to know, there's a whole newspaper inside the city that won't stop talking about them.
Okay.
Public occurrences.
I'm gonna move on. Let him go.
Chin up. Maybe someone in town can help you.
Maybe. Okay. So let's go and check out Diamond City and see what all the fuss is about. There's gotta be someone in here I can talk to.
Everything you guys do.
Oh, thanks. Glad to hear it.
Keep up the good work. This is for you. It's nothing much, but I hope it'll help the cause.
Things are tough now, but they'll get better.
What's with you vault dwellers in those jumpsuits, huh?
Huh. So I'm not the only one, huh? So it looks like you got fads, Preston. You might have been in there. Okay, so this is Diamond City. And, looks pretty good. A bit of a low frame rate. Public occurrences. That must be, Piper's sister.
If the Institute grabs you in the night, at least we warned you.
It's sarcasm.
Free paper? Sounds like quality.
I'm serious. The Institute takes people. You should read up if you're sticking around.
Hell yeah. Sure.
I believe you. Thanks.
You're a real lost lamb in the wolf's den, mister. So what are you doing in Diamond City anyway?
Missing person.
I came here looking for someone.
Let me guess. That someone's gone missing, right? That's what I'm telling you. So who is it?
My son.
I'm looking for Sean. He's my son. Less than a year old.
You have a son, mister? Man, you're old. You're in bad luck. No one tries to find missing people in Diamond City.
Missing well,
people means the Institute is involved.
And so the Institute has taken my son. Is that what you're saying, Nat? Alright, I'm going to try a charisma check on her, okay?
You're
someone
a smart
can help
kid.
Me.
Isn't there someone in town who isn't afraid of this Institute?
Well, there is the detective, Mr. Nathan. He's not afraid of anything. If anyone's gonna help you, it's him.
Nick Valentine. Well, sarcastic. I have to go sarcastic.
If his business card isn't shaped like a heart, I'm gonna be disappointed.
Yeah, I'm definitely sending you to the right place. Good luck, mister.
Okay, Nick Valentine, a detective. Let's see what we can find. Nick Valentine. Diamond City Market.
Anyone is one of those things. It's
what?
That secretary of his. Her and her perfect hair.
Mm-hmm. The mayor's secretary. Come
oh,
on, Ma.
Wow.
I cut
That's
her
all.
Hair myself, and I know human hair.
That's just it.
Okay, there's a lot of paranoia going on here about synths. Yeah, what?
With your razor, he'd bleed.
Officer? I hear there's a bar in the old theater district that's for raiders only. The combat zone. I'd stay clear if I was you.
Ooh. Raiders? In a bar? We go drink with raiders and then we could kill them? What do you think, Preston? Okay, we'll find the combat zone. I hope it's a... a Protectron cooking. Excellent.
Do yourself a favor. And just say yes. It's all he
Tell
understands.
Me a joke.
Nani shimasu ka?
Okay. Yes. The woman said, say yes. See Abbott at the wall? What?
What do you say we grab a cold? Bartender.
Excuse me.
Right here.
Nani shimasu ka?
That means, would I like a drink? The answer is yes.
You read the paper?
Nani shimasu ka?
Yeah, hiding among
just
us.
Just make it strong.
Do you speak whatever he's talking?
Takahashi.
Yes. Oh, he's giving me noodles. Excellent. Let's take those. No, I'm going to take one noodle. 1,000 fucking caps. 58 caps! For noodles. You're shitting me. No way, man. No way. I've only got 4. Get. Yeah, they want to be the best feckin' noodles in the world. What's that? Nuka-Cola Quantium. All right, so Commonwealth weaponry, that's somewhere I would like to see. Diamond City surplus. Let's talk to Percy here.
Everyone else may be closed, but Diamond City surplus is open 24 hours a day.
Well done. That's because you don't need to sleep. You sell, what do you sell, buddy?
Oh, everything, sir. Miss Myrna prizes herself on being a collector of quality odds and ends from all over the Commonwealth.
Well, I have got quality odds and ends from all over the Commonwealth. Excellent. Excellent. Let's barter.
Sure.
Anything and everything.
Okay. What have I got to sell first? Let's go to my weapons. An automatic institute pistol. I'm going to sell that. Bottle cap mine. Wow, it does a lot of damage. Flare gun. No, I need that. Institute pistol. Selling it. Junk jet. I gotta hold on to it for the moment. Laser rifle I'm gonna sell because I have the righteous authority. Security baton. Sell that. I keep the short double barrel shotgun. Short laser musket. I'm not feeling that weapon. Really, I'm not feeling that weapon. I'm selling it. Submachine gun. Do I have... maybe. Okay, so those are my weapons that I've sold. Laundered green dress, I can sell that. I don't know why I've got that. Leather chest piece. Ooh, that's actually quite good. I should wear that. I'm going to wear that. I'm going to sell this greaser jacket and jeans. Leather right. I should be wearing some of these things. Military fatigues. Damage resistance 5. Huh. Raider. I don't like the Raider stuff. I'm going to sell it. Red dress. I didn't try it on. Oh, well. This stuff I need to take back. That's my wedding ring. Welding goggles. Don't really want them. Okay. I'm gonna sell all the crap that gives me rads. Okay, we've unloaded Preston and myself and we've sold lots of stuff. We are here in Diamond City and we are looking for the detective whose name is Nick Valentine.
Word is
it's nighttime here in what?
The old museum of witchcraft up near Salem. Why would anyone even go there?
Something bad went down in the old museum of witchcraft. Let's have a look-see. In Salem. What's that? Bad TFL regional office. Malden Center. Museum of Witchcraft. I'll have to check that out at some point. Well, this is the combat zone. I'm quite close to the combat zone. Okay.
Diamond City Surplus is always open.
Okay, Diamond City Surplus is always open. Let's close this down. Hopefully in the morning we'll be able to come back and have a look at the Commonwealth weaponry place because we're going to have to buy some more ammunition.
Broke up with my girl. She kept mm-hmm. the cap off the toothpaste. Know who does that? A synth.
Okay. A lot of fear of synths in here. What the hell? Is that a butcher's? What is that?
Can't believe
it's like a big junk jet.
Only one thing we're buying dug out in.
What?
Man's gotta eat. What can I say?
A real Diamond City boy eats at the noodle stand.
Don't bother, pal. I ain't seen nothing. I ain't heard.
You read that article? Public occurrences. Damn synths could be anywhere.
Dude, calm down with the fucking gun. What's this? The dugout inn. Oh! Okay, let's check this out. The dugout inn. Might be something cool going on in here in the dugout inn. Maybe we get a drink. Meet some ladies. Oh, yeah, do a little dancing. What do you think, Preston? You're pretty good with the ladies, right? Yeah, right. Okay.
Wearing nothing but a smile. When outcomes, the most dangerous
God, it's
of
a Russians.
Monsters. A Meyerlurk!
A Meyerlurk!
A Meyerlurk?
That's like 2 out of 10 points of danger tops. Now, you want to talk something really deadly?
Redeem! Yep.
Yeah, it is. I forgot you were there, Yefim. What is it?
You know what? Never mind. I'll handle it myself.
Okay. All right, so we got people here.
If you don't live here, you ain't nobody. Got it?
You're bothering me.
Okay, these people are not very nice.
Caesar's bar? I killed a man for it.
Well, congratulations.
No, I kid. He is dead, though. Now, let me know when you're ready to order.
Okay, this your bar?
So, this your bar?
Damn straight it is. My brother Yefim and I make the best moonshine in the entire Commonwealth.
Moonshine, eh?
Dobrov's best. Had to start renting out rooms just so customers had a place to safely pass out after drinking it.
I might rent out a room, actually, while I'm here. Okay, well, I'm not interested for the moment.
Sure? Oh, well.
I'm gonna grab a quick drink. Hey, buddy. How you been doing?
Preston, my friend. Long time no see. I've been worried about you. The stories, you know?
Yeah, it was rough there for a while. But things are looking up again.
Fantastic news. Please, take a load off. Relax and have a drink.
You don't have to ask me twice.
God, Preston, you just know everybody in town. Your armor is a bit screwed. We're going to have to go back to Sanctuary soon and sort out your armor. We'll do that later, first of all. And we should rest up here somewhere.
Oh,
this is...
Need a room?
Yeah, I do need a room.
What's the story with this place?
Not much to say. We sell food, drink, and rooms. Mainly for traders that come to the area. My brother Vadim runs the bar. Scarlett's our waitress, and she helps me keep the rooms clean. As much as they can be.
Okay. Well, I'm going to rent a room.
All right. Here.
You're in room 2, just through the door.
Excellent. Okay. Preston, you're going to have to rent your own room. And we're going to sleep. Perchance to dream. And we'll drift off into dreamland. Okay, we've had our sleep. We're all ready to go. Let's go check out outside.
Have a nice day.
Thank you. Now it's daytime. See what Diamond City in the daytime is like. Yeah. Here we go. Here we go. So daytime in Diamond City. We need to find... Sorry? The Bobrov brothers. Who's the Bobrov brothers? Talk to the Bobrov brothers. Where? Oh, that's back in there. Well, we'll worry about that later. Let's go. We're just going to look around here and see what we can find. Dr. Sun's house. Okay. Dr. Crocker's house. Science Center. Do we want to go? No, we don't want to go into the Science Center right now. Diamond City Security. Third. We're looking for... Valentine Detective Agency.
What? You mean the railroad? That's a fairy tale, man. They don't exist.
The railroad?
I heard from my cousin. He knows a guy that works for him. They got a code phrase and everything. Follow... the Freedom Trail.
The hell is that supposed to mean?
Road to freedom.
That kind of talk is going to get you snatched up by the synths.
Follow the Freedom Trail. Okay, well, maybe that's something we might investigate later. But we have found the Valentine Detective Agency. So let us check it out. And we got to go talk to Piper as well, but she asked us to have a word with her before we left town, so we're going to do that. Hello?
His ties.
Hello?
Something wrong?
Another stray coming in from the rain.
Uh-huh.
Afraid you're too late. Office is closed.
Oh. It's important.
I know you must be busy, but I won't take much of your time, miss. It's important.
You don't get it. The detective, he's gone.
He's gone. Missing.
Picture on milk carton time?
If only it was that simple, right? Nick disappeared working a case. Skinny Malone's gang had kidnapped a young woman, and he tracked them down to their hideout in Park Street Station.
Okay.
There's an old vault down there they use as a base. I told Nick he was walking into a trap, but he just smiled and walked out the door like he always does.
Okay, well, who's Skinny Malone?
Who's this Skinny Malone character?
I don't know much about him, but he's from Good Neighbor, and that means he's in the well-pressed suits and machine gun school of thuggery.
Oh, one of those. What's Good Neighbor?
Malone's from Good Neighbor?
Yeah, it's a tough neighborhood. Northeast a ways. People with power there care about two things, style and body count.
Huh. Sounds like a nice place. Okay, well, I'm think that Nick Valentine might be a good person to help me out find my son, so I'm going to offer
help. I'll find
him.
You have my word.
Thank you. Nick should be easy to spot. He's always wearing that old hat and trench coat getup. Please, hurry.
Okay. Oh, do I have a minute? Sure. What is it?
What is it?
When we first met, I admit, I had my doubts about you, but you've done nothing but impress me. You're just who the Minutemen needed to bring us back from the brink.
Thanks.
Thanks. That means a lot coming from you.
You've probably realized by now how important the Minutemen are to me. When I was a kid, the Minutemen were my heroes. They were the only good guys around, really.
Need to do something about your power armor.
I joined up with Ezra Hollis's company. He was one of the good ones. Really believed in the old-time Minuteman way. We had a few good years there. I felt like I was part of something bigger than me. Like I was really helping make the Commonwealth a better place.
Well, you know, it's important to make a difference.
It sounds like you were really making a difference.
I think we were. I know we were. But obviously it didn't last. I'm sure there was a lot
of shame.
I didn't see or know enough to pay attention to. You know, the politics and rivalries and bad blood between the different groups. I guess General Becker was able to keep a lid on it, keep everyone more or less on the same team. But after he was killed, it all came out in the open. Couldn't believe it at first. These guys were supposed to be Minutemen. They were supposed to put their duty to the people ahead of everything else. You probably think I was pretty naive, huh?
Not really.
I was. Still am, too. Even after everything, I still believe that the Minutemen can be what I always thought they were. The good guys.
Well, I think they are. I agree with you.
We are the good guys.
We're doing our best. And a lot of it has to do with your example. So I guess what I'm trying to say is, thanks. Anyway, I appreciate you taking the time to listen.
I just gotta be sarcastic. I just can't help myself.
We don't have to hug now, do we?
Nah, I'm not really a hugger. Probably better get back to it.
Oh god, I hope he's not a swapping spit in the showers kind of guy. Alrighty. Ellie, we'll find Nick. Preston, let's rock this mother. Okay. Okay, so. What do we got here? Did I hear somebody say put the gun down? Uh-oh. We got something going on.
What have you done with the real Riley? Where's my brother?
I swear, I'm not a synth. Don't shoot, for God's sakes, we're family!
Uh-oh.
Put the gun down, now!
He's a Sith! He'll kill us all!
He doesn't look like a Sith. Jesus, fuck!
Kyle, no!
Okay, show's over. There are no Siths in Diamond City. Hear me? Just you folks and your damn paranoia.
He doesn't look much like a Sith to me. Would anybody mind if I took those bottle caps and that ammo?
I guess they aren't gonna need that anymore.
Well, they're not. Riley, what's the story?
He pulled a gun on me. Home brother.
Oh, I've got to do it.
Hey, who hasn't engaged in a little friendly attempted fratricide in their life?
I'm not a synth. I told him. I kept telling him. Why didn't he listen to me?
I need a minute.
Okay. Jesus.
Everyone still standing around for? Go back to your
something own for this institute group is just, they're just kind of weird. Is that? Okay. Preston.
Hey.
I'm listening.
How do I get you to get out of the power armor?
Wait there.
I'll stay
nope.
ready.
Over here.
Aye,
move
aye,
here.
Sir.
Hey.
Go ahead.
How do I get you to get out of the power armor?
Hold position.
I'd rather be watching your back. But okay.
Oh. Come on. Come on. I must...
Need something, General?
Yeah. Exit the power armor. There we go.
I need you to get out of your power armor.
Sure thing.
I'm going to put it in that power armor thing. Where are you going? I'm going to try and repair it. See, can I repair it? Okay. There's a power armor repair station over there. Servicing. I'm going to get this over to it and see what I can do. Okay. You must exit your power armor. Okay. Can I work on this while I'm here? Craft. Oh, I could add that which I've got. I can mod it with Minutemen paint. Okay. And the right arm. What does the Minuteman paint do? Increases charisma of all pieces painted. Well, you know what? Let's do it. Okay. Well, that's... Whoops, partly repaired it. What? I don't think I made that happen. Let's try that again. Equip that. Oh, it has to be repaired. T, repair. Okay, I can repair it. And then equip. And repair this one. And equip. Excellent. Okay, so it's back in semi-working order. You know what, I think I'm going to leave it there and come back for it a later date, okay? Because I don't, you know, you're not really a power armor kind of guy, right? I didn't think so. Excuse me. So we've repaired that, the power armor. We're going to leave it there. We're going to take it back to Sanctuary Hills when next we come to this area. But first of all, I need to go to my data. I'm going to turn that off. Talk to the I might talk to the Dobro brothers before I leave, so leave that on. I need to go to Piper's office, and I need to find... Valentine. So where is he? He is over near the combat zone and good neighbor. So I will go and check those out. But first of all, I'm going to talk to the two brothers who own the bar, which I believe is over here.
Got too much dirt in that hair? Get it trimmed.
I don't want a haircut. So what do these guys want, huh?
Hi there.
You can
get drinks and food here or at the bar.
Thank you.
Let's see
what
you got
to sell.
Everything's cooked or brewed here.
She's got ammo. Beer. Jumper's best moonshine. I gotta take it. Okay, it's expensive, but you know what? We're gonna take it. Whoops. No. Yeah. I'm just gonna buy the moonshine. That's the kind of guy I am, really. Dobro Brothers.
Here we go.
Quiet, you feel. All right, you. Tell me. Diamond City Radio? It's terrible, yes?
Yeah.
Makes you want to cut your own ears off.
Well, what's the issue?
So, what's the issue?
Have you not listened? This DJ Travis, he's terrible.
Makes you
want to go back in time and prevent radio from ever being invented.
That's a bit harsh.
Jim, it's true. Don't listen to my brother. Someone needs to get rid of him. We need a new DJ for the radio. I don't think many would notice if he, you know, disappeared.
You're serious? Really?
Are you serious?
Did we not just agree this is serious problem? calls for serious solution. You get him to follow you out of town.
All right. That's enough. Vadim isn't serious. He doesn't really want to kill Travis.
What's really going on, guys?
Okay. What's really going on here?
Sorry, we were just joking around a bit.
It's true. Only jokes.
Okay.
Travis is a good friend. Yefim and I worry about him.
Well, Travis, he means well, but he does not have the confidence he needs for that job. Or anything else, really. And
okay.
So he's always awkward. He does not believe in himself, you see? He expects he will fail at everything, and so he does.
Well, you know, turn it around.
Well, that can always be turned around.
Exactly. This is what I'm telling Yefim. Go on, spoil sport. Go back to working. We will figure out how to help Travis. Come, you. Meet me in back room. We discuss plan.
I'm kind of on a mission here.
Just buy or sell whatever you need and get lost.
Okay, well, we'll talk to Vadim and see what he has to say.
Hey, Vadim.
Drinks! The finest liquor moonshine.
Okay, just come into the back room.
I'd rather be on this side of the wall than the other side, you know?
The wall? Oh, at the wall of... Okay. Talk to me.
What do you want, Vadim?
I am glad you are willing to help. Unlike my deadbeat brother. Travis is a good guy. He deserves better life.
Okay.
So, what details. Do you have in mind? I'm gonna need some more in the way of details.
Ever been in bar fight?
I can hold my own.
I can hold my own, if that's what you mean.
Exactly what I mean. I want you to back up Travis in his first fight. I want to stage fight here in Dugout. Nothing too serious. We make sure Travis wins and feels good about himself after. I want you to be there to help make it look real. What do
okay.
you think? Sound good to you?
Sure, I'm on board.
When do we start?
Why not soon as possible?
Okay, as soon as possible.
Contacts, people I can count on. Real tough looking. But they will take a dive for money. They confront Travis here at Dugout. You step in and give him push he needs to stand up to them. Then you and Travis take them down. Nothing gets too rough. And Travis is something he can feel good about. Simple, right? I have
right.
everything ready by 6 o'clock. Travis should be here by then. You show up and it will go well. Promise.
Okay. What time is it now? 2:36. This could go very, very wrong. The first thing I'm going to do is get rid of all my weapons. Because, quite frankly, I don't want to accidentally kill anybody. I want to kind of go sleep in my room for a couple hours.
Just don't throw up all over my floors.
I'll try not to. Okay, let's sleep sleep for 3 hours. That'll be just before 6 when I wake up. Okay. I feel well rested. That's good. This is probably going to go wrong.
Lost? You in room 2?
Ah, yes.
I know. Where's the time? I had the time up here, Data. Okay, a few more minutes. A few more minutes and we'll be on. I can go and talk to a few people while we wait. Hey, how are you?
I ain't your friend, Scabber.
I didn't say you were. I was just... Ooh. That looks like cheesecake. The claw says who stays and who goes. Aww. Actually, some of the other stuff looks a bit crap. Okay. Hawthorne.
What?
Talk to me, buddy.
What's your story? Mercenary, caravan guard.
Neither.
Wrong on both tries.
I can usually spot a hired gun on the first look. Maybe you just give off an armed and dangerous vibe.
Anyway, that's what I'm going
for. I'm just back and sharing stories while I'm between things. I've been all over, seen vaults, pre-war ruins, and plenty of monsters.
Monsters?
Let's hear your best monster story.
I'm from Diamond City. You want to talk something really scary? It's the Institute of Sense. Don't go to University Point. Trust me. You don't want to know what they're capable of.
Okay. Pre-war ruins.
Last place I was going to check out was Salem. Real old town farther to the north. Made it though. Got a bad feeling about that area.
Okay, what about the vaults? You said there's vaults?
Yeah. Ever heard of Vault 81?
Nope.
Standoffish, but every once in a while, they'll let new people in.
Huh.
See you around.
A vault. I might check that vault out. Let me have a look. That's Vault 81. Salem to the north. That's, yeah, Museum of Witchcraft is in Salem. University Point, to be avoided. Okay. Radio.
What you gonna do about it?
Oh. That's Travis. Bull is one of the hired guns. I imagine Gouger is too.
Oh, what's wrong? Not so tough once you're not on the air.
You tell him.
Hey there, pal.
What's this about?
Oh, it's you.
Everything okay?
Everything okay here?
Does it look okay? Because, no, it is not.
I have no idea what I did to deserve this.
I have no idea.
Go away.
Well, why don't you make a stand, huh?
Come on, man, take a stand. Don't chicken out here.
I don't think I could do that. Thing that you're describing.
I bet you could.
With these men, it could, well, it could turn violent.
Mm-hmm. Don't be a coward. I got your back.
Don't worry. I've got your back.
Well, if you think it would work, well, okay, that's enough.
Oh, I'm sorry. You say something.
I said, that's enough.
Hey, Bull, you should hear what Travis said about your mother.
Look at you. Let me think about that for a second. Nah, I don't think so.
You don't think? Whoa, 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 whoa. Something weird just happened. I don't know what just happened there.
I mean it. Leave me alone.
Okay, we're going to fight him. Fight him.
Saying, or else. Were you, Travis? Were you going to say, or else? I'm wondering what comes after that. What you going to do, little man?
Come on, Travis. Punch him in the face. Kick him in the balls.
Mistake, Travis. I'm going to destroy you and your friend here.
Hey. Yeah. Yeah, come on. Yeah. Smack. Smack-a-rooney. Oh, yeah, yeah. You think you're pretty good, do you? Yeah, Gouger. Gouge this, motherfucker.
Oh, God, my jaw.
Yeah, Bull.
Bullshit. This is bullshit, man. This is not what I signed up for. This ain't over. You hear me?
What do you mean it ain't over? It's over. You got your ass handed to you.
Whatever it is,
get the hell out. Okay.
Oh,
you alright, Travis?
Hi.
You okay?
Travis.
Whoa.
Yeah, there we go.
We did it!
We did it! We kicked their sorry asses. How do you feel, man?
How do you feel now?
I don't know. I mean, wow, wow! I never thought I could that was crazy! Wow. Hey, listen, thanks.
That anytime,
was
buddy.
It was really something. I think maybe I should go lie down now.
Yeah, solve your problems through violence. That's what I always say. Solve your problems through violence. All right, Vadim. Job's done.
I think that went well.
I think it did go well. Well, there goes Travis. He's learned to that his fists talk and bullshit makes bullshit walk. So, right, I got things to do. I got to go and find this Nick Valentine guy, and we'll be doing that soon enough.